Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here, New Life Pentecostal Church, Albany, Georgia. Hope you're having a great day in Jesus. We're going to just start a little bit of examining differences in the ESV and the trusty King James Version. This is a large print Cambridge King James we'll be using. And I have to say, this particular ESV, Crossway's done an amazing job of bringing out just great quality ESVs. And I just like the setup of this. But we're looking at the text today. So let's go to Matthew 17, 21. And so in the ESV, Matthew 17, 21 is just not there. It's in this first paragraph. I'll have Brother Mallory, first column here. I'll have Brother Mallory see if he can zoom in on that. Matthew 17, 21, whereas here it says, howbeit this kind goeth not out but by prayer and fasting. Howbeit this kind goeth not out but by prayer and fasting. So like a big spiritual warfare passage is just missing in the ESV. And we're going to look, and Lord willing, we're going to do several settings of this. We don't have time to do it all in one setting. And we're going to see that there's many words, phrases, not just changes, not just it's easier to read, but there's a lot of things missing in the ESV. So 18:11, Matthew 18:11. Wow, Matthew 18:11, down at the bottom of the second column and at the beginning of the third column on the other page, you'll see it goes directly from Matthew 18:10 to 18:12. And so that scripture reads, for the Son of Man has come to save that which was lost. Now, I think it's hilarious. I've got buddies of mine that really, my fingers are in the way here, that defend that. Well, it's found in other scriptures. Well, what if you only have Matthew? You know, for the Son of Man has come to save that which was lost. And the Bible, you know, repetition's the mother of learning. And it's in there the exact number of times it should be in there for us to be, you know, man shall live by every word of God. So it's just totally missing. Matthew 23:14, let's see, and this is a condemnation of the Pharisees. It says, woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you devour widows' houses and for a pretense make long prayer. Therefore, ye shall receive the greater damnation. Let's see what it says in the ESV. And wow, here at the bottom of the second column here, you'll see it just goes from verse 13 to verse 15. But woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you shut up the kingdom of heaven against men, for you neither go in yourselves, neither suffer ye them that are entering to go in. So you might say, well, maybe it's just the book of Matthew. We're going to see, the book of Jeremiah is emasculated, and it goes from Matthew to Revelation in the New Testament. So you can fight back and forth on the translation, but you cannot fight back and forth on the fact that they are materially different. And we're talking tens of thousands of words shorter, at least in the case of the NIV versus the King James, and I would assume that's going to be somewhere close to the case, 60,000 words shorter in the NIV. I've got a buddy of mine that still disputes that fact, even though it's a common fact among, you know, everybody that studies the subject, but it's going to be about the same in the ESV. So this is just kind of a starter look at the King James versus the ESV. God bless. Talk with you later in Jesus' name.